You can't play well if you don't look good. Serena Williams. I totally agree with what she said. However, does that mean that you have to look like a supermodel every day at work? Absolutely not. What it means is that you must dress up in a way that makes you feel good, because this is key to performing well. In this video, I'm going to tell you exactly how you can dress up in a way that makes you feel confident and that helps and contributes to you performing better at work. But does that mean that I'm going to tell you about colors you should wear? Does that mean that I'm going to tell you about styles you should wear? Absolutely not. I'm just going to be sharing with you three basic rules that I use that are going to make the process easier for you to understand, and you'll be able to dress up better no matter what the occasion and feel great about the way you look. So let's start. Hello everyone, I'm Mansi Agarwal, International Soft Skills Corporate Trainer, and today I'm going to be telling you about dressing and what are the basic rules to follow. Let's start. Rule number one, appropriate. What does this mean? How suitable is your attire for the occasion and for all the other things? How suitable is it for what you're going to do? When I consider any dress for an occasion, I always ask myself six questions. The questions are, number one, how suitable is my dress for the occasion? If I'm going for a wedding, I'm going to be dressed differently. But if I'm going for a board meeting at an organization, I'm going to be dressed completely differently. So number one, occasion. Number two, role. What is your role in this occasion? If you are the bride, you're going to be differently dressed at a wedding. And if you're just a guest, of course, your dressing is going to be completely different. So understanding very objectively what your role is and what you are going to be doing at that particular occasion really helps you understand how you should be dressed. Number three, venue. Where exactly will this occasion be held? Is this an event that's going to be held outdoors? Is this going to be indoors? Ask yourself all these questions, because really these are going to make it much easier for you to dress up in a way that's appropriate for the venue. Number four, weather. Is it the rainy season? Is it going to be extremely cold? Is it warm? The weather really has a huge role to play in the kind of clothes we choose, and I seriously consider and I hope that you're going to be mindful of the weather as well. Number five, how are other people going to be dressed? You know, it's really important to understand that we do not want to stick out like a sore thumb. Yes, it's great not to be one of the crowd. Yes, it's great to be different, but you don't want to be the sore thumb. There's a fine line of difference there. You want to ensure that you are dressed somewhat similar or within the same range as the others. I know the embarrassment of dressing up in a black dress at an occasion where everyone else around me was wearing saris, and I didn't feel very comfortable at all. Therefore, I genuinely hope that you'll also consider what the others are dressed like. And number six, also somewhat important, is what time of the day is the occasion going to be at? Is it going to be in the morning? Is it going to be in the day? Is it going to be at night? Because even the time of day really has this ability to sort of change the way we dress, not drastically, but definitely something that you would want to consider. However, here is my one rule that really overshines and outshines all the other things I've said. If you ever have to choose based on how appropriate it is, and if you're not sure whether to underdress or to overdress, I like to go with overdressed, because overdressed is fine, but underdressed or not dressed suitably for the occasion is certainly not fine. Rule number two. The second question I always ask myself is, how authentic is my dress? What do I mean by authentic? I mean, how much does the dress represent who I really, really am? I think this is extremely important, especially for people who are trying to find their right style, their right voice in the world. For me personally, there are certain things that I'm extremely conscious about, no matter what the occasion, no matter what I'm dressing up for. And these things are, number one, colors. I don't wear too many bright colors. Number two, very, very rarely do I wear prints. Number three, I'm notorious for wearing not so much jewelry. And number four, I also like to dress up in monochromes. However, this is just me. You don't have to stick to any one of these rules, but what you must always ask yourself is, how authentic and how comfortable and how good do I feel about myself and my real self in this dress? Does this show off who I really am? If you're able to ask yourself this question over and over again, you'll find that not only are you able to sort of develop a certain sense of style for yourself, but also Through consistent practice of dressing up authentically, you will be creating a brand for yourself, something that makes people relate with you and know that this is you. The brand I think I've created for myself in the way I dress is that I dress in a sort of professional manner pretty much all the time. But even when I'm at a wedding, you will most likely see me in few colors and absolutely no prints at all. Question number three. The final question I like to ask myself is this: how does this make me feel? Every time I'm going out somewhere, I realized that the more confident I feel, the better I am, the better I perform, the happier I am to meet people. Confidence can come from different factors for different people. For me, it doesn't come from diamonds. For me, it doesn't come from a fancy bag. For me, it comes from a good fit, a good cut. It could be something different from you. So you must ask yourself, does this make me feel confident? If the answer is yes, go ahead and wear it. If it doesn't make you feel confident, but you're wearing it just because it's comfortable, ask yourself again, is it okay to not be so confident at this occasion? If yes, then go ahead. Otherwise, try and opt for something that makes you feel great, even if the heels sometimes hurt. Because truly, that could make all the difference in the way you perform, in the way you speak to people, in the way you behave there. So here's my tip. If I personally have to choose between comfort and confidence, I generally go for confidence because really that helps me perform better. But the pick is yours, the choice is completely yours. I hope that through this video, I've been able to answer some of your questions, and I hope that you are going to use these questions the next time you have to dress up for an event where you need to feel great about the way you look. And I also hope that the next time you open your cupboard, you're able to see your entire wardrobe in a new light and you're able to rediscover new purposes for the clothes you already have. Enjoy the journey.